it's nonsense what Kratz is going around saying, the pure nonsense and false, a lot of it, about what was left out of the film. And, you know, he's going around saying that there was sweat DNA found on the hood latch. Now, that was presented at trial, but it wasn't sweat DNA. There's no such thing as sweat DNA. Their own expert from the crime lab testified that they never did a presumptive test on that hood latch to see if there was blood there. And that she said, I can't foreclose the possibility that it was blood that formed the from which the DA came. It was a discolored swab, so she didn't visibly see blood, but she also testified under oath that there are many cases where you don't see it, but if you do one of these presumptive tests, you'll find it. She didn't do that in this case. Nor did she do that on the key that was found in his. So, you know, his argument that there's somehow a vial of perspiration that must have been planted too is just totally bogus. It's absolutely false. Secondly, the expert also testified that the quantity of DNA, the amount that was found on that hood latch, was very, very, very small, and that it was consistent with the kinds of the amount of DNA you might get when someone inadvertently transfers it. There was testimony by another, I believe, one of the analysts who was inside the car doing blood stain pattern analysis with gloves, then goes around and opens the hood latch himself with the same gloves without changing them. And he did that because they wanted him to get the odometer reading. And he had to open the hood to reconnect the battery in order to get that. And so, you know, that whatever DNA was found in there might have been innocently transferred by the analyst himself. So, you know, for Kratz to say that that somehow was the strongest piece of the case, it was not that important a piece at trial. And for whatever reason, the filmmakers had to make decisions about what they could cover and what they couldn't. You know, so at this point, you know, it's sour grapes for Mr. Kratz, frankly, to go around and say that this film is doesn't cover so much of their case. The vast majority of the state's case was presented.
Some of my best friends like Star Wars, don't get me wrong. But Star Wars has magic in it. You know, it has the Force, and it's really about family conflicts, and it's Shakespearean. It's this nobility, essentially.